so excited to be joining my husband Dana in his creative space, which is our kitchen. My creative space is out back in the studio, and Dana is our family cook, which is a good thing because I burn things, and we'll talk about a little later. But Dana's joining me to share with you one of our favorite family recipes, a recipe that he came up with on his own, and that is
Venison Chili.
Absolutely. It's a great, warm, cozy kind of comfort food on a nice cold day, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Okay, so tell me, obviously with chili, meat is involved. What are we using?
What I've got here to start off with is 5 pounds of ground venison.
Great, great. So if they don't have a hunter in their family, they don't have venison, what can they substitute?
Well, you could easily go to your farmer's market and find a buffalo or elk, and a lot of farm-raised venison is sold these days too.
Okay, so it is available.
Oh, certainly, you can find it.
And I think you said buffalo, which is also known as
bison
buffalo.
Sure.
I know that there are a lot of meat vendors like that. And, all right, let's get started.
Okay, what I'm going to do is just brown this off over medium heat. And this is going to take about 10 minutes because we have so much here in the skillet.
Oh, it looks like you're making enough for the army.
Well, this is a great recipe to freeze.
Okay.
And so it's great when you come home late from work and want to just pop one in the pan and warm up.
And I've never known you to make little portions of anything.
That's true too.
You are in for a treat because this is actually one of my favorite recipes, and I don't know if Dana knows this, before I met him, I didn't like chili, but I love his chili. I still don't like meatloaf, but I love his chili.
So, wow. It's good to know.
That is good to know. So, okay, we're going to let the meat.
Well, it looks like the meat's browned, and so all I need to do is take this over to the sink and drain the fat off of it. Okay, I'm just going to let that sit and drain. What I have here next is I've already chopped up 3 stalks of celery, or 4. Add this to our skillet. I've got 3 green peppers and 5 sweet onions. I'm just going to saute this until it's just slightly tender.
So I noticed that you didn't add any butter, there's no oil or anything in this.
That's correct. There was just enough oil still in the pan or fat from the burger. So just in trying to keep this as low fat as burger could possibly be, I don't add any bacon fat to it.
And one of the nice things about working with venison meat, and we do process our own venison meat, is that we control the amount of fat, so it's a much leaner, heart-healthier meat to use.
Absolutely. Venison, or any game meat, is much lower in fat and higher in protein than domestic meat, so it is better for you also. Well, this looks like it's about ready, so I'm just going to set this off to the side and set up my chili pot.
That's one big pot.
We're not messing around.
No.
Okay. I'm gonna add in the burger. Alright. Okay. Then once I've added the burger in here, I'm simply going to place the vegetables inside the pot. Okay, the next thing I'm going to add is 4 pints of our home canned tomatoes. And these are whole tomatoes that we've simply canned. And notice I have not drained the liquid off of these. And I like a little kick in my chili, so I'm going to add 1 can of Rotel. Then I've chopped up 3 jalapenos. And with the jalapenos, you can add as many or as few or none at all as you prefer. I'm gonna mix this up. Smells amazing already. I'm gonna go ahead and add my seasonings. I've got 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. Oh yeah, babe. Teaspoon of salt. 1 teaspoon of black pepper. And 4 tablespoons of chili powder. I'm gonna give this a good stir. I'm going to bring my heat up to a boil. I'll be right back. Okay, well, it looks like we have a nice boil going on with our liquid in here.
Smells so good. I wish they had smell-o-vision. Oh, it really does. It smells awesome. My goodness, there's a lot of liquid in there, but I didn't notice that you put any liquid in there.
Well, the tomatoes will cook down just enough to provide the necessary liquid for this recipe.
Okay. And one thing, I see you got a lot of jalapenos in there, and I really don't like it spicy. Is that your normal amount of jalapenos? Or did you add? You did. You made it spicier than normal, didn't you?
Who, me?
Yes, you, silly boy.
Okay. Well, I'm going to just lower this heat.
Put this
to low.
You're going to get off the jalapeno thing, huh?
So I'm trying to evade that.
Okay, but if you don't want jalapenos, I mean, you have to have
You don't have to have the jalapenos.
Okay.
I just like the heat.
I know you do.
I like it hot.
He is in hot water, too.
Okay, I'm going to cover this, simmer on low for 1 hour. Okay, so it's been about an hour. Let's check it out.
Oh, a fast hour.
It's the magic of television.
It smells so, so good.
Okay, now what we're going to do is just simply add our beans. And I've got 2 cans of pinto beans.
So you're not
going to
drain any of the...
No. Keep the liquid in here. 2 cans of pinto beans. 2 cans of dark red kidney beans. You can always do the dishes.
Or not.
Okay, that looks great. I'm just going to cover this again. Simmer for 30 more minutes.
I suppose you want me to take out the spoon, right? Is it ready?
I think it's ready.
Great. Oh, look here. I already got my plate ready. There it
Imagine
is.
That.
Scoop it in.
Okay. Oh, that smells good.
All right.
There you go.
Well, I'm going to show everyone how I like to doctor mine. Okay, this is how I like to do mine. First, I want to put a little dollop of sour cream. Gotta top it off with a little bit of cheese. Let's dig in. Dee's laughing because he thinks I put too much sour cream in there, but I like a lot of sour cream. What can I say? Now it's time to dig in. If you missed the recipe, you can get the recipe on LindaPetersonLive.com, so be sure and check out the website.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's gonna be good. Good job, then.
Thank you. Mm. Mm. Oh, delicious.